Hello, YouTuber. In today's reloading series, we are going to explore basic operation of the press. I just love using my drawing reel too. Okay, we can excuse the mess in here. Anytime we have something, we don't know where it goes, it ends up in here. Okay, so, Steelmaster 10 gauge. This one I can, hopefully we can see what's going on. Okay, so. This comes off. And your charge bar slide out. And here's the collar. The collar's going here. Okay. The shot didn't run the collar, but the powder got various collars. Now this one here is 45A. This restricts how much powder ends up going in the shell when you operate the lever. And you also have what's called one of these that you can adjust. See, some of these you can actually adjust them. But I don't usually do it this way, so it doesn't really matter to me. Anyway, on the mech press, this can turn completely over like this. And you can load powder. Load powder up. You can see. Okay, now. Gunpowder. Steel. This is an older one. I got this at a yard sale or something for $20. Then it helps to have a funnel. Actually, we'll use this one. It's right there. Anyway, you'd think, oh, gunpowder, you don't want to shake it because it'll go bang. Well, no, that's not true. This is very, very stable. In fact, you are supposed to mix it a little bit once in a while. It needs to be slightly agitated once in a while because otherwise it can settle out and you can get, there's different compounds in here and you can end up with pockets of more of one compound than another in different spots. So you'll have irregular velocity, irregular burn time and so on. So as long as this is well mixed, the shells will work uniformly. You can just fill that up. Screw this on here. This screws on. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing here. Now you can do it this way, or you can load it from the top. You can load it from the top too, so you just got these plugs. But when you go to unload it, you're going to have to flip it over so that you can get that off without losing all your powder. The shot, of course, goes on this side. Now let's see. I'll use. Now this Steelmaster 10 gauge is from designed for 2 to BB shot. Just the way it is, out of the box. So, I'll put 2 shot in there. These are heavy shot or something. I have those separated for some reason. Okay. I'll do it the other way. I'll go ahead and put them on like this up here. Just like this. Pull the plug out. First of all, so we'll put this thing as paces. This is an old speed shock, Federal. Use the sizer. Let's remove the primer, the old primer, and sizes the case. And then I just happen to have Federal primer in there. Primer's in. Now, I'm going to put this down. Hopefully you can see this all right. While this is down, first we need to put this back. Otherwise, I can lose control of how far over it goes. You don't want that to happen. It's got to be put together. There we go. Now, it's down in the shell. Make sure it's in the shell so powder doesn't spill everywhere. And then, I need a cameraman. Okay, this should be all the way over, so the powder should be in there. Okay, powder has dropped in there. It's in there. Now, never assume that the amount that's in there is the correct amount. We want to go with, say, 36 grains, so we'll go to the scale here. And I think I've got 35, all right, got 36 right there. Let's see how close we are here. I think that puts out about 42, but I can't remember. Oops. Okay, it's a little bit high. Still too much. Oh, that's good. Spill powder everywhere. If you do spill powder, don't fret. You can just clean it up. Okay. Yeah. It's close. And now what to do with the old powder? Since we had excess, I'm going to put it back in here. Like that. And dump this into the shell. And now I need a wad. Okay, for a wad, I use it's not flood water I'm going to use. TPS, ballistic products TPS, 10 gauge, 3.5 inch, and slit shot tip. Now you can get them slit already, they'll have 4 pedals. And they work great, but I prefer to slit my own, which will be something that I'll discuss in a later edition. There's a reason I prefer to slip my own wads. And I go with 3 pedals. This on the machine. Now, most people just call that good, and then you dump the shot in. However, I prefer to make sure it's all the way down. This is actually for tightening the primer hole, which is something else I'll have to discuss later. I just push it down, just make sure it's all the way down. It wasn't. Yeah. Next thing you do is back in the shell, and we're going to dump shot. And you see, it falls short. So, I have to put more in it. So in this case, spoon. And put more in it. Okay. Okay, so that's actually, it's a little bit light. You want it to, you don't really want to go past the shot cap. I've done it before, I've experimented, but when you go past the shot cap, you do risk scratching your gun barrel. I'll put it back in here. Now, again, 10 gauge overshot card. Put in here. Now, see this little gauge right here with numbers on it. Slow burning powder has got to be compressed to go bang. So, I usually run, say 50, 70, something like that. You can probably get away with a little bit less, but run some wad pressure on there. I'm going to go over here to this side. This is the crimp station. That starts the crimp. And then, this finishes it. And voila. We don't actually know. We did not measure the shot. Now, I always measure them. But I know what those wads hold. That's about 1 5/8 ounce. That's a perfectly good shell. Unload this thing. I've got to take this off. Pull that off. So, make sure the plug is in. Flip it over, and you can detach both of these. And that just matches. And pull the shot back in. Now, a lot of people, see, I used to just leave it in there, but it's not a good idea. Powder can absorb moisture. If you got moisture in the air, the powder can absorb it, and then it's not going to work properly. So, it's always good to store the gunpowder in its original container. Yeah, I think those came out of a heavy shot shell, those other ones. And then see, now you can just screw these back on. Good. You have everything back together, then it's fine. But like I said before, I don't do it that way. I hand load the shelf. I just use the press to put the pressure on. Now this one, this Lee loader, there's the various tools and so on inside there. Now this is, well, this goes right here. That enables you to put the wads in the shell without them hanging up on the crimp. This is the collar, and probably for powder. It could be for shot, some of them here. This is the same way, shot powder. You got the slider switch, same type of thing. A little tricky to unload compared to the other one. But with it, see the, you start over here actually. Gets the primer out, and supposed to size the shell, I don't know how good it is. Puts the primer in. This does all, loads the wads, shot, powder, and then this starts the crimp. And actually, this finishes the crimp. This one, as I recall, no, that one. Okay, that finishes the crimp. This one is 6-point crimp. And that one's an 8-point crimp. It's normally on most of your old crimp shells, your light loads, target loads and stuff usually have 8 points, and then your game loads usually have 6. But you could do them either way. It's not really, it really doesn't matter. And then there's roll crimping. That's something else we'll discuss another time. It takes a lot of time to cover all this information. I know I'm not going very fast, but I want to be thorough. There's plenty of videos on YouTube that just show someone doing basic stuff and they don't get into the specifics. I'm getting into specifics. The shot, if you wanted to leave the shot in here, you could. It's not going to go stale. Although, if it was a real moist environment and steel shot, it could rust. That's something to think about. Say you lived along the coast and got the salt air, that could be a serious problem. What you might want to do in that event is maybe spray some oil on there, WD-40 or something to keep it from doing that. Now, of course, you got to have a scale. You really do. And I use this one for shot. In the old days, well, in the lead days, when my stepdad and I were loading lead in shells, we had Lee loaders, and they were, it came in a box about yay big. It was just a set of dies, and you had the thing the shell fits in. It didn't have a press. You were the press. And so it was important to have a clean surface to work on, because you didn't want anything sticking up, and you put a primer on it, and bang. Anyway, it's these precision dies that you use, and you had all the stuff available to take the primer out, put the primer in, resize the shell to an extent. And it wasn't, if your shell is way out, it's going to stay way out. But and you had the crimper, the crimp starter, and everything else. And also in the box, you had paper with recipes, load recipes, of course. A few of them on there. And they had various die sets, some for 20 gauge, 2 3/4 inch, some for, that's what I used, 20 gauge, 2 3/4 inch, and 12 gauge, 2 3/4, 3 inch, and 10 gauge, 3 1/2 inch. And I don't know how much one would go for now if you can find it. I don't think they make them anymore, but you can find them on eBay once in a while. And of course, back then we were loading leaky load, like all leaky loads. We were using the fiber wads. There was no plastic shot cap most of the time. Which actually makes a difference on your choke if you think about it, because modern chokes are designed for a shot cap. The shot cap changes the size a little bit because the plastic itself takes up some room. So a full choke back in the day might be slightly different than a modern full choke. Plus the different brands, they vary a little bit. But I digress, and I'm not going to get into a big choke discussion right now. Anyway, that's basic operation of the press. I know it seems long-winded for just a simple device. But don't do like I did and leave the plug off when you go to flip it over. Flip this over. And I forgot to put the plug in. That's what happens when you forget to put the plug in. Like I say, I never use the shot powder containers. I don't use them now. I do everything by hand, which I will show you that another time in another video. And you people on Patreon that support me, Thank you very much. That really does help. And the rest of you, thanks for watching. Please like, hit that like button, and it'll make the algorithm keep it on there. Share it if you want to. Thanks for watching.